GAC has finally made local Landfall, the latest Chinese brand to arrive here in Malaysia, and they are set to take the market by storm with the new GS3 M-Zoom, a B-segment turbocharged crossover set to go head-to-head with the Honda HR-V, Proton X50 and Chery Omoda 5. With prices starting at a whisker under 120,000 ringgit, is this now the B-segment crossover to watch? My name is Aiman Ai Abdullah. This is Malaysian Motoring. This is our launch coverage of the GAC GS3 M-Zoom. Now, as I mentioned earlier, the GS3 M-Zoom is a B-segment crossover, which means, as I mentioned earlier, it goes head-to-head with the Chery Omoda 5, Proton X50, as well as the Honda HR-V, among many other entrants. Now, although there are two variants on offer, there are some similarities. For example, the powertrain, which I'll need to refer to my notes here. There is a 1.5-litre turbocharged four-cylinder engine producing 177 PS and 270 Nm of torque, with power going to the front wheels via a wet 7-speed dual clutch. Now, 0 to 100 is rated at 8 seconds, just 8, with the fuel economy rated at 5.9 litres per 100 kilometres based on a Chinese testing cycle, which means realistically, it's not going to do that. However, because of that four-cylinder powertrain, this should be a little bit smoother than what we've seen from other car makers that offer turbo threes, so it is at least promising. Now, regardless of whether you go for the exclusive, which is the entry level to the lineup, or this, the premium R, other certain specifications remain the same. So for example, rolling stock is handled by a set of 18-inch alloy wheels wrapped in some Century tyres, spelt with an S. Now, brakes are handled by a set of disc brakes, front and rear ventilators on the front, with a McPherson strut up front and a torsion beam in the rear, which is basically par for the course for B-segment crossovers. Now, as standard, you do get these split LED headlights with a very distinctive Mecca-inspired front end, with these very, very distinctive LED daytime running lights, with the full LED headlights living just beneath. And of course, the indicators are set up front. Now, this being the premium R, of course, you do get certain embellishments, such as an additional body kit, three orange stripes on that front grille, as well as more orange bright work along that body kit. Coming down the side, you get the R-style badge here, which kind of goes against what the official model naming is. But one of the things I find most interesting on the side are these flush door handles, which deploy when the car is unlocked, as well as these very geometric styled side mirrors, which I think are the most distinctive I've ever seen within the segment. Now, the back of the M-Zoom is certainly very distinctive indeed, with again these Mecca-inspired LED tail lights, replete with your indicators in here and your reverse lights over there. And of course, because this is the premium R, you also get dual central exhaust tips flanked by a rather sculpted but largely useless rear diffuser. Now, as far as I'm concerned, as far as B-segment crossovers are concerned, looking distinctive and looking bold is very important to win buyer approval, and so I think this should certainly look very different from everything else in the market. Now, behind this tailgate, you will find a boot which measures in at about 341 litres. Now, this is not large by any measure because you certainly get more space in other competitors, but it is big enough for most people. And of course, underneath this boot floor, you will find a space saver spare wheel, which means that should you want to go further afield on your adventures, at least if anything were to happen, you have a space saver there. Now, I will note that while the inclusion of a standard fit power tailgate is certainly very generous, there is no parcel shelf, which is a very strange omission. Now, on the inside of the GS3 M-Zoom, everything does look pretty good on the surface. You get a 10.25-inch center infotainment screen replete with wireless Apple CarPlay, although no mention of Android Auto. And you do get some USB-C ports up front, although apparently that is reserved only for this model, which seems like a very strange omission. You also get a digital instrument cluster up front, which should provide all the relevant information that you need in a manner that should be relatively easy for you to absorb, so that's all very good. And of course, for this top-spec model, you also get a panoramic sunroof, electric powered driver's seat, and everything here does look quite nice. You also get remote engine start, which is certainly nice to have and is becoming a bit more standard within this segment, at least with the Chery Omoda 5 and Proton X50, so so far, so good. I do appreciate the fact that the interior build quality seems pretty good as well, with a very generous choice of materials with a lot of soft touch stuff everywhere, including some stitch stuff up here, some lovely contrast stitching on these seats. And I do appreciate this black and blue interior tone. There's also this crystalline gear selector, which I must admit is kind of nice. Now in the back, despite this car's relatively diminutive dimensions, I have to say there is an absolutely palatial amount of knee room and a decent amount of headroom despite that standard fit panoramic sunroof. So everything here does seem quite nice. Unfortunately, while interior build quality remains relatively plush and upmarket and practicality is well served by lots of pockets and space in here for your flotsam, and as well as this nice center armrest, which feels surprisingly solid despite the price point, there is a single USB port and a single central mounted air conditioning vent, which is unfortunate. At least, however, the ISOFIX mounts are relatively easy to find and these doors open a decent way, which means that fitting a child seat should not be too difficult. So it's a bit of a mixed bag, but pretty decent for 120 grand. As it turns out, there is wireless Android Auto, so I guess it's always a good thing. Now, whether or not you go for the Premium R or this exclusive variant, there are some benefits to being an early adopter of GAC. Because the first 2,000 customers will enjoy 3 times complimentary scheduled service maintenance, including labour, parts and lubricants, which is equivalent for 3 years free servicing, a 7-year 180,000-kilometer engine and powertrain warranty for the first registered owner, non-transferable if you were to sell your car, in addition to the standard 5-year 150,000-kilometer warranty, and you also get a complimentary limited edition GAC smartwatch key, which doubles up not only as a smartwatch with health tracking and so on, but also as an additional key to your GAC, which certainly looks far more stylish than anything we've ever seen before, and that watch alone is worth about 1,400 ringgit. Now, as I mentioned earlier, both of these cars are relatively well equipped in terms of standard safety specifications as well. You get level 2 semi-autonomy, which means things like autonomous emergency braking with pedestrian and cyclist detection. You get lane keep assist, a standard surround view camera, as well as various other features. So all these specifications are what you'd expect from a B-segment crossover entering today. So far, so good. All that remains to be seen is whether or not these cars can hold their own out on the open road. Now, I'm certainly excited to see what GAC has in store for the M-Zoom for the local market, as well as where they intend to expand further on, because Warisan Tan Chong, the official distributor for GAC here in Malaysia, has big plans in terms of CKD operations, export potential, as well as expanding the lineup very, very soon. So, let us know what you think about the GAC GS3 M-Zoom in the comment section below. Is this now the B-segment crossover that you're most interested to learn more about? And more importantly, let us know what you think about GAC and its plans for Malaysia coming up. In any case, that has been our launch coverage of the GAC GS3 M-Zoom. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell icon so notified every time we make a new upload. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. You can join our new WhatsApp channel. All the links are in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Take care and stay safe. We'll be right back.